So we'll talk a little bit about the lean supply chain building blocks. What are they? And at the base, you see a transactional relationship, moving to an information sharing relationship, and finally a collaborative relationship. Transactional relationship is really fairly traditional, what you normally see in supply management, where it's a purchasing type of an organization, buyer-supplier focus. You're looking at inventory levels, service levels. Maybe you have electronic data interchange or vendor-managed inventory type of transaction taking place. Quality standards and performance, that's the first building block. When you get to an information sharing relationship, now you're really looking at the next step moving towards collaboration, where you're starting to share schedules, you're starting to do collaborative demand planning, looking together at what is the future demand going to be, doing collaborative planning, forecasting, and replenishment. So you begin to look at time buckets and when you make commits for bringing in certain parts to your supplier, having performance improvement metrics, not just metrics on past performance, and looking at e-business relationships. And then building on those, you can create a collaborative relationship, which is really future-focused. You're looking at working with key suppliers, at future business, at leveraging their capabilities, doing combined facilities planning, capacity planning, and sharing benefits, sharing the incentive of a lean supply chain with your partner in business. Sharing the costs and benefits of collaboration, you have a local minima that you can achieve through lean manufacturing within your own operations. There's kind of a barrier to entry because you've got to push through the investment of time and energy in working with these key suppliers. But if you do that, then you can achieve more of a global minima in terms of cost, a unit cost, by creating a lean supply chain and increasing collaboration.